Hi friends, my name is Emma and let's talk spooky stuff. Welcome back to my channel and welcome to another Hidden Gems video. I haven't done one of these in a while and today we're going to be focusing on recent foreign horror movies, films you may have missed, films that may have gone under your radar, or films you may have seen the name of and you just didn't really pay attention. I'm here to remind you and to give you a good description of what films may suit your personal taste. If you don't know me, my name is Emma. I'm also known as Spookyastronauts here on YouTube. And every single week I do videos based on horror and thriller and dark cinema to give you a lot of recommendations, to break down some movies and just to have a chat. But if you are looking for someone who can recommend you movies on a weekly basis, spoiler free, I'm your gal. I'd love if you subscribed, and if you do find this video helpful, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And in saying that, let me know how many that I mentioned today that you've seen. We have 7 on this list, so let me know below in the comments, out of 7, how many you've seen. Let's get started because I have something here for pretty much everyone, but I do want to start with a very gory film called The Swarm. Gore fiends, gather around, listen up because it's your time to shine. The Swarm is our French entry on this list. The film is about a single mother who is struggling to make ends meet. She lives on a farm with her daughter and son, and they're locusts. Yes, this isn't a normal farm, it's a locust farm, where she farms locusts in means of protein. But business is slow and she's struggling to produce the quantity and quality required, until an accident proves to be the answer. This film is part drama and part dark, brutal horror. It's a beautiful and unique story that is bound to have your skin crawling. I really do like the idea of joining the family struggle both socially and financially because of her passion of the locusts with brutal horror. It's a slow drop into pure darkness that you won't be forgetting anytime soon. I think this one is rated criminally low on IMDb, especially for the quality and impact that it has on its viewers. And another pro for The Swarm is that it's easily accessible. You can find this one on Netflix in most countries. Check it out and let me know what you think. Next, we have a South Korean film that went under everyone's radar. And thank you so much to my friend Scott who recommended this to me. I can't believe currently this film is sitting at 54 reviews on IMDb. It is the definition of a hidden gem. This is for a whole different audience. If you're into goofy, fun, satire comedy horror that focuses on authentic hauntings, Show Me the Ghost is bound to have you smiling. The story follows childhood best friends Ye-ji and Ho-do. They're both struggling with finances, and I guess this is a little bit like The Swarm. But that's where the similarities end. In this one, Ho-do moves into a rental property that seems too good to be true, and his friend overstays her welcome, crashing in the house, which turns out to be in his favor because something's not right. And the last thing he wants is to be left alone in a possible haunted house. The film works because of the banter between the two leads. Their platonic relationship is something rarely executed in horror films, and it's done really well. But the cherry on top is that the film itself is a satire on the stereotypical haunted house story. It's a fun watch that wraps up in a satisfyingly charming way. Next, there's no such thing as the perfect family, right? Well, Rock, Paper, Scissors is here to prove this to the extreme. This is a twisted Argentinian nightmare paired with an ominous soundtrack. This independent film is bound to give you the creeps. The film toes the line of darkness in the most uncomfortable way. Dysfunctional families. Rock, Paper, Scissors is about two sisters and a brother who are reunited after the death of their father. But when estranged, successful sister Magda arrives home, it's clear she's not like her brother and sister at all. In fact, she thinks she's a little bit better. And sister Maria is not bowing to her needs. You could basically cut the passive aggressive tension with a knife. But the tables turn when Magda must rely on her brother Jesus and twisted sister Maria to survive the visit. Creepy Maria's unnerving delivery is what makes this film so intense. The dialogue will have you dreading seeing any relatives this coming Christmas. The film has a more dark drama feel to it, but it crosses the line several times. The dialogue is killer. check this one out if you're looking for something a little bit more creepy and ominous. Next, I've never heard anyone talk about Folklore, the anthology horror series by HBO Asia. Each episode is set in a different Asian country and focuses on folklore in that region. Season 1 has 6 episodes and they run for 50 minutes each. They don't rely on flashy production or stylization, but unique and sometimes dark concepts that tell the story of their culture and beliefs. Season 1 has stories from Indonesia, Japan, Singapore, Thailand, Malaysia, and Korea. It has a very Masters of Horror feel to it. The first episode, called A Mother's Love, is from Indonesia and it's directed by Joko Anwar from A Pentagore and Satan Slaves. The episode follows the story of a mother and son who flee their home and have to live in a house that she is cleaning for work. But when strange noises are heard, it's very clear that they're not alone, and her strange discovery will change their lives forever. I thought that this one was actually really surprising. The tagline for the series is Origins of Fear, and it really does measure up to the core of what the stories are about. It's less about the high production jump scares and more about where they actually come from. The origin of the folklore itself. Back to some good old-fashioned gore, The Trip is a twisty tale like no other. Because this one is directed by Tommy Wiikula of Dead Snow and What Happened to Monday, I knew I was in for a roller coaster, but yet I was not prepared. This is a Norwegian film starring Noomi Rapace. The Trip is about a couple on the verge of a breakup who head to a remote cabin to reconnect. Little do they know that one of them may not make it out alive. This film puts toxic relationships to the test with a hint of sarcasm and a lot of gore. The performances are exhilarating and the film itself does not miss a beat or give you a chance to catch your breath. This is a genre-bending film that brings unique storytelling into a simple concept. Don't sleep on it. German film Blood Red Sky got a lukewarm applause online, but I feel like it skipped a large portion of the horror community, even though I believe they would enjoy it. This film is a lot more serious than the rest on the list. It's a drama action horror that really takes flight. I mean that. It's on a plane. The film is about a woman who tries to protect her son when their plane is taken over by a group of terrorists. In order to save her son and to help fight evil forces, she must face her own darkness and use it to her advantage. The film aims to tug on heartstrings with a really strong arc for the main character. I don't want to reveal too much, but if you are a fan of action horror, make sure to add this to your watch list. It's on Netflix in most countries, so I hope you check it out. Last but not least, a classic horror story is the definition of unique. The film starts with the premise of 5 mysterious strangers meeting, and they're forced to spend time together carpooling in a motorhome across the countryside of Italy. But their ride gets derailed and they find themselves stranded in the middle of nowhere. But it's not exactly what it seems. Not only must they search for a way out, but they must fight to stay alive. This film has so many layers, it's honestly impossible to predict. It's a really fun ride that will have you gasping the whole way through. And it is led by Matilda Anna Ingrid Lutz, who some of you may know from Rings. Let's say Revenge. She was great in Revenge. If you've been putting off this Italian horror movie, bump it up on your to-watch list, because I promise, if nothing else, it's a very unique journey. That's it. That's the list. Let me know how many you've seen and let me know if you know of any unique foreign horrors that have come out in the last couple of years that you think went under everyone's radar. In fact, I do have a recommendation list. It's always linked down in my description box if you do want to check it out. If you want to go in there and recommend me a movie, maybe I can pick a bunch of them and do a whole video on that. Let me know if you're interested in that. But that's it for today. Thank you again for watching. My name is Emma, also known as Spooky Astronauts. I do 2 videos every single week talking about horror movies and thrillers and giving you a lot to put on your to watch list. I hope you're having a fantastic day, and if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. It does help me out, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Stay safe and stay spooky. Bye, friends.